Good morning children, how are you all? Already we discussed about the bones and muscles. Already I explained you bones and muscles. How many bones are there in our body? Already explained you about the bones and muscles. There are 206 bones are there in our body, isn't it? In newborn babies, how many bones are there? Already explained you. What are the, how many bones? 305 bones are there in newborn babies. Skeletal system, which gives protection to our body, which gives shape to our body, which protects the delicate internal organs, isn't it? And what are the parts of the skeletal system? Already explained you, that is skull, rib cage, backbone and limbs. Skull protects the delicate organ, that is what you call it, brain. Immovable joints are there in the skull. Okay, and how many bones are there in the skull? 22 bones are there in the skull, isn't it? So it protects the delicate organ, that is brain. Which part of the skull is movable? Only the lower jaw is movable, isn't it? Upper jaw and lower jaw, we have bone, teeth are fixed in upper jaw and lower jaw bone, isn't it? So this is about the skull. Coming to the rib cage, how many bones are there in the rib cage? 12 pairs of bones are there in the rib cage. These bones in the front, we have the flat bone, it is called as a sternum. These bones are connected with the sternum and here it is bent and it is connected backside, that is with the backbone, isn't it? And last two pairs of the bones are called floating bones. Which organs are protected by the rib cage? That is heart and lungs are protected by the rib cage. Next, coming to backbone. Backbone means, you see, flexibility is there. It works like a spring. How the spring will be there, how it molds. In the same way, our backbone also helps in bending our body, isn't it? Keep dancing. Flexibility will be more with the backbone or spine. You will see the small rings of the bones. These small rings of the bones are called the vertebrae. How many vertebrae are there in our body, in our backbone? That is 33 vertebrae are there, which makes the vertebral column. Which part is protected by the backbone? Spinal cord is protected by the backbone. What happens if the backbone is having only one bone? There are no vertebrae. You cannot bend your body. Understood? Next, coming to the limbs. We have two types of limbs, that is forelimbs and hind limbs. These are called the forelimbs and these are called the hind limbs. Forelimbs, this is called the bone. Is called upper part of the arm is called the humerus and lower part of the arm is what you call it, radius ulna. It is called radius ulna and these two are connected with the elbow, isn't it? These are connected with the elbow. What you call it here in the joints, what is present? Ligament is present. Cartilage holds the bones together. Understood? Next, coming to for hind limbs. The hind limbs are what you call the upper part of the hind limb is called a femur. It is the longest bone in our body, which bears the weight of our body. It is called the femur. The next part, which is connected with these two parts, are these two bones are connected with the knee joint, isn't it? So lower part of the hind limb is have two bones, that is tibia fibula. Understood? Now we are, so these are the parts of the skeletal system. Okay children? Wait. So next, coming to types of joints. Already we discussed about the types of joints also. Joints means the part which is movable. Movable. Joints means where two bones meet is called a joint. The part where, a part where two bones meet is called a joint, isn't it? There are four types of joints, already explained you. What are the four types of joints I explained you? What are the four types of joints I explained you? That is ball and socket joint. Ball and socket joint. And which one? Fiber joint. Next, sliding joint. and hinge joint. These are the types of joints. Joint means where the it is movable parts, isn't it? Where the joints moves easily. Ball and socket joint, where you find a ball and socket joint? In the shoulder and in the hip region, we find the ball and socket joint, isn't it? Which rotates in all the directions. It rotates in all the direction. It is called a ball and socket joint. The ball of the, what do you call it? The ball of the arm is fixes into the socket of the shoulder bone, isn't it? This is called a ball and socket joint. Pivot joint, where you find the pivot joint? In the neck region we find. See how we are moving up and down, sideways, rotating. These are the movements you find in the pivotal joint. Sliding joint, where you find the sliding joint? In the wrist, in the ankles. Sliding joints are present in the wrist, in the ankle part. Sliding joints are slide with each other, which helps in movement, isn't it? This is what you call it, sliding joint. Next, coming to hinge joint, where you, it works like a hinges of a door. So it is called hinge joint. Where you find the hinge joint? In the, it works in only one direction. It works only in one direction. It moves only in one direction. So in elbow bone you find, in knee joint you find, even in the fingers also you find, toes and fingers also you find the hinge joint. Which joint helps us in plucking the flower? Hinge joint only helps in plucking the flower, isn't it? So now what happens if you don't have the joints in the fingers? Can you do the work? The hands will be, the palm will be like this only. If a single bone is there in your hand, if single bone is there in the fingers, what happens? You cannot do any work, you cannot hold the things, you cannot bath, you cannot eat the food, nothing, isn't it? So the hinge joint also very important. So joints are very important for our movement. Okay children, have a nice day. Take care.